ladies and gentlemen, and we are a group of extremely tired Avengers. I am going to try and speak very slow and very deliberately, and hoping you will pick up on what it is that I am attempting to do. This is the team. We must also apologize for one of our members. It's his daughter's birthday today, so he couldn't spend the whole day here and not go and spend the day with his daughter. But this is essentially the Avengers. What is our problem that we are trying to solve? The lack of convenience and ease of access when it comes to accessing pharmaceuticals when you are sick at home and you just do not want to face the inconvenience and the schlep of leaving your house. So you would really rather have a solution where you are at that point in time. How do we fix this problem? Our solution is a virtual mobile medical assistant, which will, number one, request or ask you what your symptoms are. After you've given it its symptoms, it then runs through a corpus that we would have built for it to be able to process language. Then it would then give it diagnosis, recommend a home remedy that you might utilize at home at that point in time to help you. Or the third option that will pop up on your screen is a ping that will come from one of our partners, Care Technologies, that will then tell you where the nearest Dis-Chem, the nearest Medi-Rite pharmacy, and the nearest Clicks pharmacy is, pinging a list of over-the-counter drugs that you would be able to purchase from either one of these pharmacies and be able to get treatment without having to go and see the doctor. But then there's another inconvenience that leads into that. What if I generally still do not want to leave my house? And this is where we felt we would want to plug in an innovation that would speak to South Africa, would speak to localizing of the technology, but also connecting people through these technologies that we would be utilizing. We then came up with a system that is called Shova to Good Health. Now this is a community initiative that we will run where we will get people who are unemployed, get them on bicycles so that they are able to then commute and collect these drugs from these pharmacies and then deliver to the sick patients at home. Then just executing a payment, ensuring that that person is then receiving medication. But what we will also do, we will not only focus on people that have that kind of access and that kind of money, we will also then show you the nearest clinics to you where you can access free government medical assistance. Our key partners, we have utilized IBM Cloud Platform for image recognition, and it's one of the plugins that we will talk about as we were talking about the app. Care Technologies for, of course, pinging, but at some point in time when we are talking about bicycles and people making these transactions, we will need a partner in making payments. As a result, we hope that MTN would push the South African rise of the mobile money app. How are we making money? We are going to sell the data complying to POPI laws, ensuring that when we are selling these remedies, the remedies will be able to then recommend to supermarkets that along this time in the season, people tend to purchase these types of remedies a lot, so stock up on that and we'll be able to capitalize on the data. We would then capitalize on advertising from the pharmacies that we would be pinning their products, and then of course the service of the Shova to Good Health ambassadors that we would have embedded in our communities. Customer relationships, we would keep them innovation, ease of service, convenience. I'm going to skip this part just so that you get to see some of the demos.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, just a quick look to the screen. That's actually a model that we're training in order to incorporate audio, speech to text. But seeing that we're running out of time, I'm just going to run through the models that we've actually built for our system. So for in the case whereby you have a physical injury and you don't know exactly what it is, we will be using IBM's virtual image recognition system. It will actually just take your picture, send it through, it analyzes it. And as you can see on the far my left, it actually shows you can pick up if it's like a microorganism, a virus, the color of the skin, what type of injury it is. And then based on that, we'll know if to recommend to a medical facility in time. Now this is just a quick demo of our actual NLP chatbot that we have. It's called Dr. Strange. Now here's a simple example. It's basically saying Dr. Strange, like, okay, hi. It's like, how may I help you? It's like, I have a headache and a fever. Now basically it's gonna read through the script and then it says, okay, you might have diarrhea. In fact, come to think of it, wait a little bit. Come to think of it, this model is actually quite better than the one we had yesterday. Because yesterday I put in the same things and it said that I might be suffering from analytics.
How do you deal in this case? I think another group asked this. You have an access between, you know, on one part you're trying to do some telemedicine and do some diagnosis, and that's not going to be easy, not just a technical issue, but then how do you get around regulatory issues, right? Because at the moment it doesn't seem here the doctor lies in the loop. To the revenue stream of trying to advertise through connection to pharmacies and medicine, it also seems very shaky. Because of ethical issues. So how do you deal with some of these ethical issues?
If I may just add to that, what data are you going to sell and for what purpose?
Okay, now. All right, now to put this. Now, in the case whereby with the regulatory, in terms of how we diagnose and whatnot, we're going to have the assistance of pharmacists and doctors. I apologize for not incorporating in that. That's why we have the actual image recognition system that's built in. That will be built, that information there will be for the medical practitioners or medical facilities. What we're going to do is we're going to look at ailments that, like, something that's very basic, like a cold, something that you can treat at home. Or if it's like an emergency, middle of the night, you hurt or something, you can't get to the hospital right there and then. We need to give you something just to keep you, like, let's say you're in pain, just to kind of like minimize the pain as such. We're not saying we want to replace medical doctors or whatnot. The regulations, they are still going to be there. Medical practitioners are going to be involved. We cannot build this without them. They have the knowledge and everything. Even the corpus we have here is from the medical practitioners themselves. Am I answering the question about the regulation?
So the question on the data. That is the new oil. So number one, what we would never do is we would never take personal IDs of our users and ever pass them on to anybody. So what would be is, let's say the chatbot recommended that you get these remedies. 3 days later, that would have been saved. The robot will come back to you and ask you, how are you feeling? Are you feeling any better? And if you utilize those remedies. From that feedback, we are then able to say, you utilize these remedies. Let's check this trend. How many people are utilizing this remedy at this point in time, and is it working? And if that is working, then it is a model that you can sell for to people who are perhaps run supermarkets or things like that, to know what they must stock seasonally and those kinds of things. This is where we were taking the data, but we would never share any personal information because we know that is totally against the law. The pictures, we could have built it better. We got 5 decent pictures, but it was just, the wounds were very disgusting. We wouldn't have been able to put them there and keep food in their stomachs.
Thank you.